Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel. Let us discuss about the drugs used for the treatment of erectile dysfunction. The sexual stimulation causes stimulation of the important nerves called cavernous nerves, and the circulation is called cavernous circulation. That generates endothelial nitric oxide. From the endothelial nitric oxide is generated, which enters into the circulation in the target tissues. That is the tissues in the penis, and that causes solubilization of the guanyl triphosphate to soluble guanyl cyclase. That stimulates the cyclic GMP, that stimulates protein kinase G, and this increases the intracellular calcium, which leads to smooth muscle relaxation, vasodilation, which increases the blood flow to the cavernous spaces, and that induces engorgement and erection of penis. Actually, this cyclic GMP is metabolized by an important enzyme called phosphodiesterase 5. So, this phosphodiesterase 5 is inhibited by a set of drugs, PDE5 inhibitors called sildenafil, vardenafil, tadalafil, and avanafil. Since they are blocked, the biological half-life of cGMP is increased, which leads to treatment of erectile dysfunction. Let us see about sildenafil. It increases the penile tumescence during sexual arousal, but it does not affect the penile tumescence during the absence of sexual activity. It is erroneously perceived as aphrodisiac. It is not aphrodisiac. It's metabolized by CYP3A4. So CYP3A4 inhibitors should be cautiously used when they are combined with the sildenafil. Sildenafil at lower doses are used to treat pulmonary arterial hypertension because it increases the pulmonary circulation. Ambrisentan is an endothelin receptor antagonist. It's a new drug for pulmonary arterial hypertension. The adverse effects are headache, nasal congestion, dizziness, facial flushing, and loose motions for the sildenafil. Relaxation of the lower esophageal sphincter may cause gastric reflux and dyspepsia. Sildenafil is also a weak inhibitor of PDE6 that is present in the retina, that is responsible for phototransduction. It may lead to blue-green discrimination that is affected because the patients cannot differentiate blue and green. It may also cause adverse effect called non-arthritic ischemic optic neuropathy. Sildenafil should not be combined with organic nitrates because it leads to fatal fall in BP. It can cause myocardial infarction, so it is contraindicated in patients with coronary artery disease. Tadalafil is a congener of sildenafil. It is having longer action, so the nitrates are not advisable for 3 days after taking tadalafil. Due to its lower affinity for PDE6, visual disturbances occur less frequently. It may cause back pain because it may inhibit PDE2. It is also approved for treatment of pulmonary arterial hypertension. Vardenafil is very similar to sildenafil, similar to its action and interactions. It prolongs QT interval, so it is contraindicated in cardiac patients. The other unusual therapies are papaverine with phentolamine penile erection therapy, injection into the cavernous space, which produces penile tumescence to permit intercourse. It is used only in cases where PDE5 inhibitors are refractory in nature. Adverse effects are priapism. Repeated injections may cause penile fibrosis, hematoma, infection, and paresthesia. Alprostatin is a PDE1 analog, PGE1 analog. It is injected into the cavernosum before the intercourse, which can lead to erection of the penis. Priapism and penile fibrosis are rare. A transurethral pellet medicated urethral system for erection, MUSE, has been developed, which avoids the intracavernosal injection. It is less effective, but it may cause urethral burning. So, it's a short nutshell information of all the drugs used in treatment of the erectile dysfunction. I hope it will be useful for you. If you like this video, kindly press the like button. Kindly share this to more of your friends. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for further updates. Thank you.